Welcome to my video with Mikira. Today we're going to do a follow-up video from my setting up Loopbacks for Pulse Audio with a new video about streaming to Hitbox TV using a Bash script. So let's begin. We'll take a look at the script we're going to be using. To do the streaming, we're going to be using FFmpeg, so ensure you have that installed on your system. It does normally come pre-installed, so you should be okay. Right, the script itself is quite a short script, really. We'll just run through it. What we've got is our input resolution. Mine's is 1280 by 1024. That'll be the resolution of your monitor. Our output, which will be shown on the stream, I've set 1024 by 790. That's the minimum for HD. Your targeted frames per second, I use 22. The quality of the encoding, this is an FFmpeg preset. I use ultra fast. If you've got a low bandwidth, you're best probably using ultra fast. Medium to semi-low, say medium to fast. And if you've got really good fast internet connection, you can probably get away using slow. Next, we want our stream key. On Hitbox, you log into your account and click on details, and at the bottom you'll see show key. Just click on that and copy and paste it into here. Now, the script itself is used by FFmpeg. So we've got our window grabber, our input res, FPS, our screen position. If you only got one monitor, you're fine. If you're using two monitors, this will be the setting for your first monitor. Our sound, video codecs, output res, our sound codecs, and here, this is the RTMP server that we need to use to stream to Hitbox itself. Of course, this script you can also use with twitch.tv if you prefer. So if you prefer to stream to Twitch, replace this section here, the RTMP address for Hitbox, with this here, which is RTMP for Twitch, so you can just switch in between the two of them. Right. Now, after you've copied and pasted this, because this script will be in the description, I shall also probably put a download link for it. Just save it as streaming.sh in your home folder, and you have to ensure it's executable. So the easiest way to do that, right-click on it, permissions, and click to enable executing. Okay, so that's the script sorted. What we want to do now is open up a terminal window. So open up a terminal, and what you want to do is, if you've saved this in your home folder, it's fine. If you've saved in a different one, you'll have to navigate to your folder, which is CD, and the path to your folder. I've got mine in my home folder, so I don't need to bother with that. And all we'll have to do is /streaming.sh and execute it. And what you'll see is this will start coming up, and as long as you have nothing, no problems, it'll just continue streaming. So we shall nip to my Hitbox account, which is hitbox.tv/KiraEV. Feel free to subscribe to it. So let's see how we're doing. So we can see here live viewers, we are live 1 when it's initializing. So that is us successfully.
Sackboy's on a mission and he's got backup. Introducing Toggle, odds on.
That's us successfully connected to Hitbox TV. And that's all there is to it. Play about with the settings to optimise them for yourself, because it is just a generic script. But do remember, first, if you want to stream your audio and your gameplay at the same time, please refer to my previous video about setting up loot bags for Pulse Audio. Next, in the next video, we shall start looking at the different pieces of software that you can use on Linux to actually stream to Hitbox, Twitch, YouTube, which will include Cast Awesome, Simple Screen Recorder, and Screen Studio. So thanks for watching, and if you found this video useful, please do subscribe to my channel. Cheerio!
Your secrets, if you really look at yourself, you would be speechless. What happened to being doctors and teachers? What happened to being your brother's keeper? Nowadays, kids more.